Hey, what's up YouTube? It's your Uncle Sam here, and I've kind of got a quick review on my Kimpex Nomad ATV rear trunk and seat that I got and put on my Polaris. Kind of a quick review, and I'll also kind of show you how I installed it. And so to install these, the box actually comes with these U-bolts with little wing nuts on them. And they would probably work well for most ATVs. They'd work well with anything that had a tubular steel rack, but the Polaris's actually have this plastic rack on them, so I figured something else out. So what I did to install it, I've got it uninstalled here so I can kind of show you, is I just bought these on, I got them on eBay. I think they're called GripPRO or Pro Grip. I bought a six pack of them on eBay. They weren't too expensive. They're pretty simple little things. If you knew where to get this rubber at, you could probably just build it all with hardware parts. They're really pretty simple. But what I did is I had this 1-inch piece of aluminum laying around. And so I just drilled some holes in it to mount it to the box. And then I drilled holes in it to line up with the two back holes in the Polaris rack. And then just put the plugs on there. If I did do it again, or if you're gonna do it, you might wanna use a 1.5-inch piece of angle, because the little Pro Grips, they came with these eye bolts originally, but where I was only using the 1-inch piece of aluminum, I couldn't turn the eye bolts to tighten them down, so I had to go to the hardware and get some other bolts. But if you use the eye bolts, then you wouldn't even need any tools or anything to install it. So I got that mounted, and then I actually took the rack off and flipped it upside down and set it on the box so I could figure out where to drill the rest of the holes. So set it on the box. I actually used one of the rubber plugs to put in the hole, and then I just ran the drill right through it. And the box fits really well on there. All the holes line up. If you're smarter than me, you might be able to make a template without taking the rack off, but that seemed pretty well. It wasn't too hard to take the rack off. There were just 10 of these little bolts that you pull out, and it comes right off. So that works well. Did I mention that I cut a little slot in there for the strap to fit through a little bit better? I kind of just hacked that out of the aluminum. Anyway, and then you just put it on there, give it a push down, and then you go and just tighten up the bolts, and it actually holds it very secure on there. And I'll show you on the inside. You just twist these until they're pretty tight. They do stick up inside the box. So far they haven't been an issue. If they are, I can just get regular bolts and put in there. But again, with the eye bolts, you don't have to have any tools or anything to take the box on and off. So that is how I mounted it. As far as the box goes, I'm pretty pleased with it. It gives you a ton of storage in here. Like, it will fit a full helmet, like, very easily. Like, plenty of room for that. Plenty of room for coats and jackets and your lunch and everything. It's got the pass-through storage on there, which would be nice if you had a little bit more room to stick stuff through there, but it's got plenty. Oh, here, I'll show you the bolts. Can see it better on this side. The same way I did, I think I got 1.25-inch bolts, and I actually had to cut two of them down so they would fit in there. So if you're gonna do it when you go to the hardware to get bolts, I would just get 1-inch or maybe even 3/4-inch bolts, and I think they would be long enough, and then you wouldn't have to cut them down. And then these are just 4/4-inch bolts that I bolted the bracket to the box with. And like, I've had it in the back of the truck going down the highway at like 70, and it stayed on there tight, so no problems with that at all. I picked the Nomad box. They have a couple other cheaper boxes, but some of the reviews online weren't very good with them. The Nomad box has a rubber seal all the way around it, so when you close it, it stays sealed pretty good and keeps the dust out. And the Nomad box has these latches that keep them secure, where some of the cheaper boxes just had, they kind of looked like bungee cords that just held it down. So it does have this little storage area back here that a 1 gallon gas tank fits in. When I was thinking about buying it, I thought, well, that will be really nice on long trail rides, but honestly, I haven't used it yet, so we'll see if maybe this summer I'll take it on a long ride and see if it's handy or not. I did get it from Rocky Mountain ATV. It does have these nice little padded handles to hold on to. Oh, and this is pretty cool. It's got a little door right here, so you can get into the trunk. You can put water bottles or whatever you want right in there and reach them without opening the main door. And this door has also got a seal all the way around it to keep the dust out. The seat, this is the bottom of the seat, if you can see it all back up. It is pretty thick. That's probably 3 inches, maybe 2.5, 3 inches thick of foam. And it does have a little rising area in it to kind of help you stay in the seat. It just actually Velcros in position there, but that seems to hold it in place fairly well. And in the instructions, it recommends you remove it if you're gonna haul it on an open trailer or in the back of an open truck, because I think it would blow off. Actually, if I'm just going out by myself, I don't even take it with me. And if you have somebody sitting back here, you almost don't need it because they're sitting mostly on the seat and then just using the backrest on the trunk. So, but the seat does give you an extra couple inches of padding and it's pretty soft. So, anything else on it? It does, I've had it out in the dust. You can tell it's all covered in dust, and it has done a really good job of keeping the dust and the water out of it. So, and again, with those Pro Grip, or I think it was Pro Grip anchors, you just tighten them down until they're fairly snug, and they've done a really good job of holding it down. If you're gonna mount it this way yourself on a Polaris, you might get away with just using these four, then you wouldn't have to make a bracket in the back, but I figured six is always better than four. So anyway, hopefully that video will help you out. Oh, and another thing with this is the whole top of the box is fairly removable without any tools. You can pull the pin out and undo that, and then the back of the seat comes off fairly easy. It just has, I think it's got five of these little wing nut bolts in here. And so you can kind of have a storage bin instead of a full box, but I don't think I'm ever gonna use that, so. Anyway, hopefully this video helped you out too. I'm gonna try and get some more miles on here. I have put some more miles on it since my last video, but get out and ride a little bit more, and then I'll give you another short video on getting how I'm liking the Polaris so far. Anyway, well, we'll talk to you later. Bye.